Hello everyone, Igor Ekimov is with you. Today we will look at professional hydraulic press pliers. For crimping tips, Connecticut 4570 from CARTOOL. These press pliers are designed for crimping copper and aluminum ferrules and sleeves from 6 to 70 millimeters too. Compact dimensions and low weight allow this tool to be used where other tools are problematic to use. These press jaws provide a force of 5 tons and do not require electricity. The use of hydraulics allows you to get good results with minimal effort. If you are interested in tools and equipment for the home handyman, then subscribe to the channel and press the bell. Special thanks for your likes and reposts. Thanks to the compact size of the press jaws, they are convenient to work in cramped conditions. The pliers have a safety valve that protects them from overload. The head of the pliers is rotatable, which allows the pliers to get into hard-to-reach places. The handles are rubberized, which prevents the tool from slipping out of your hands. The pliers are well assembled and well painted. Judging by the weight, the manufacturer did not skimp on metal, and they will last a long time. This valve can relieve pressure and release a jammed terminal or sleeve. The head turns only when the valve is open. The set of press jaws includes inserts 6, 10 and 16 square millimeters. They are most often used in electrical applications in home networks. But liners from 25 to 70 square millimeters are more often used in the energy sector and in production. The kit also includes O-rings for servicing the press jaws. The earbuds themselves are held in place by magnets and can be easily removed. Now we've removed them and can just as easily put the earbuds back in place. Press jaws with inserts are supplied in a branded case. It is convenient to carry the tool from object to object. What can you do with these press jaws? This means crimping cable lugs, connecting wires using sleeves, and making connections in junction boxes. I will now show you how to do this using these pliers. Before doing crimping, you need to select suitable liners for the sleeves. Why am I raising this question? So I ordered 6 square millimeters sleeves. As a result, I received 4 square millimeter sleeves, although even on the packaging of these sleeves it was written that they were 6. You can, of course, check this with a caliper, comparing their sizes with the data in the table, but you can take a sleeve and select press inserts for it. Here we take the sleeve that was sold to me as 6. We take the 6 liners and see that this sleeve has nowhere to shrink. At the same time, we take the tens of sleeves, the tens of liners. And as we see, there is a distance where to compress it. The same thing with the sleeve and liners for 16, there is a distance where the sleeve should be compressed. Let me show you how the process of compressing the sleeve goes. For example, I took 10 liners and a dozen sleeves. Here we stung the cartridge case. Relieve the pressure. This is what a compressed sleeve looks like. Here's a hexagon. Let's connect 2 stranded wires with a cross section of 10 square millimeters. Using a sleeve using the crimping method, we take a stripper and strip both ends of the wire. This stripper is professional and I am going to review it. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss this video. We insert the wire into the sleeve. Make sure that the wire reaches half the length of the sleeve. We also make sure that all the strands of the stranded wire are in the sleeve. We inserted the sleeve into the pliers and clamped it. At the same time, we make sure that the wire does not fly out of the sleeve during crimping. They've squeezed it. Relieve pressure to remove the sleeve. Here we have such a connection. The wire sits tightly, you can't pull it out of here. Now all that remains is to insert the wire here, and you can clamp it again. So I inserted the wire and we'll clamp it. We clamp it. Here we have the sleeve clamped. Relieve the pressure. And we got such a connection. All that remains is to put on the thermo cambric and insulate the connection. Let's crimp the cable lug. Cable lug 10. Here is our PV3 wire with a cross section of 10 square millimeters. We insert it. Let's take our press tongs. I usually close the jaws a little before inserting the sleeve or tip. The wire is inserted into the lug. We clamp it. That's it, the tip is clamped. Release the valve. We take it out. We have a connection like this. The tip is firmly attached to the wire. If we need reconnection, then the only thing we can do is cut off this tip. Now let's make a connection that can be made in a junction box. For this, short sleeves 6, 10 and 16 are usually used. We choose a sleeve that will fit all the wires that we need to connect. If there is any free space left in the sleeve, fill it with wire scraps. Here in sleeve 10 I fit 4 wires with a cross section of 2.5 millimeters too. I made this preparation in advance. Now all we have to do is place the sleeve in the pliers and clamp it. It is important to know that the wires do not need to be twisted before crimping. To prevent them from falling out of the sleeve, they can be bent, as was done in this example. If you need to connect 2 wires, then replace the remaining 2 wires with scraps and then crimp them. Close the valve and pressurize. Relieve the pressure. Our connection is made by pressing. All that remains is to bite off the wires coming out of the sleeve. And use thermal casing to insulate the connection. All wires in the sleeve are clamped tightly. So I made another blank. This is a sleeve for 16. 7 wires with a cross section of 2.5 millimeters too fit into it. Close the valve. We insert the sleeve and pump. We make sure that the sleeve does not move relative to the pliers. We clamp it. We clamped the sleeve. Let's go. Here we have such a connection. The wires are held tightly in the sleeve. This connection is strong and reliable. We also bite off the excess wires and insulate the connection using thermal cambric. If we are installing a lighting network and using a 1.5 millimeters 2 wire, then we use sleeve 6 for 4 wires and sleeve 10 for 7 wires. The connection is made in the same way as for a 2.5 millimeters 2 wire. To make it convenient to clamp with these pliers, you don't need to skimp on wires. And you need to put them in a box with a margin so that they come out a little from the box for connection. After we have made the connection by crimping all the connections, we then insulate them and carefully place them in the box. If you have experience installing connections in junction boxes using sleeves, please describe it in the comments. I think that other viewers will be grateful to you for this. General impression of the CARTOOL press pliers and the crimp connection method. These press jaws make a reliable connection, so I recommend them and this connection. In addition, crimp connection is recommended by the electrical installation rules, respected by professional electricians. I am attracted by the high speed of working with these press jaws, and also by the fact that electricity is needed to work with them. Small size and swivel head allows you to crawl almost anywhere. Thanks to hydraulics, working with pliers does not require much effort, so you can work with them for a long time. These pliers are suitable for professional electricians, private homeowners who do their own electrical work, and also for DIYers. These pliers are good as a tool that you will use often. The only drawback is that the connection is not detachable. If you have any questions, write them in the comments. If you have experience with these mites, also leave them in the comments, other viewers will be grateful to you for this. I left a link to these press pliers in the description. Share the video with those who would find these press pliers useful. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss new videos. Like and see you in new and old videos.